Good evening, friends. Let's start our today's lecture. I'm Dr. Kanade, and we will see today the remaining part of the looping in assembly language for PKTNF-458. In our previous lecture, what we have already seen is some of the instructions like this, and these are called conditional branch or jump instructions. What it means is they will branch or they will jump to some other location provided certain condition is satisfied. Now those conditions are different. For example, this instruction, if executed, it will jump to some other location if the carry flag is set. BC branch if carry C is equal to it will branch if C is equal to 1. Similarly, there are total 8 conditions on which there can be a jump. Okay, these jump instructions are based on the values of 4 flags: carry, 0, negative, and overflow. Okay, these 4 flags from the status register or state, they are simply called status flags, are checked, and based on their values these instructions can jump to some other location provided by the label. Okay, these are short jump instructions, means the target of the target address of where we want to jump has to be within 256 bytes of the contents of PC, means at the current location. Okay, the problem now you might have seen is this thing. If you can imagine, the jumping means from current location to going to some other location in the program memory to execute some other section of the program, that program has to be a short program, like means within this 256 byte range. But what if you are writing a large program? Okay, that is one thing. And what if you want to just shift your control to some other location after running certain number of instructions? That is also possible. Means without checking any condition, can you jump to some other location? The answer is yes, we can jump to any other location what we want. Okay, and that is done through unconditional branch. Okay, now what unconditional means? As the name suggests, it is unconditional, means without any condition this instruction will branch. Branch means jump to some other location. And an example of this unconditional branch instruction is this go to. If you remember, we have seen one program already using the go to instruction. Okay, so what this go to instruction stands for is it is unconditional branch. Okay, its syntax is simply go to k. Now actually you are not going to write the k as given here in our program. While we write our program, we are going to write a label where we want to jump. Okay, the assembler will automatically convert that label into this kind of operand, this kind of address. The same thing is true for the conditional jump instructions also. We are going to write the labels where we want to jump. Okay, but still the point to be noted here is the operand or this k is 0 to 1048575. Now can you see some relation between this and this? Okay, actually this number is, can somebody tell me how much is it? Yes, is it something like this? Can you check? It is actually, you can see it is 1 mega, right? 2 to the power 20 minus 1. Okay, so this is that number. Means what? the k. Actually, when we are going to write our program, we are going to write simply the label where we want to jump. The assembler will automatically convert that label into this kind of a value. Now, the specificity of this particular instruction goto is it can jump to anywhere within the entire 2 m byte memory range. 2 m byte memory range means what? We have our program memory, right? If in your first unit we have seen in the architecture and ROM organization, we have seen that the total program memory that we can access or we can have in PKTNF family is 2 megabytes, right? And that comes from PC equal to 21 bit. Equivalently, the address bus to the program memory is 21 bits. Okay. Now, the point here to be noted is you can see what we are claiming or what this instruction is claiming here, that the goto allows an unconditional branch anywhere in the 2 MB memory range, right? But for accessing 2 MB memory, how many bits do we want? Do we need? We need 21 bits, right? The address bus is 21 bits. We need 21 bits to write down the address of 2 megabyte memory. But here in the instruction itself, what it is saying, the value is only 20 bit, or you can see the range here. The value is 20 bit. Then how is it saying that we can go to any location in the program memory? That is what is very interesting trick here. Okay. The trick is the LSB of PC. PC means program counter. LSB means least significant bit. Okay. So when we have a program counter, something like this, okay, bit starting from 0 to 20 means these are the total 21 bits of PC. Okay. So when we are jumping to some other location, we are ensuring that this is zero. The LSB is always zero, and these 20 bits, right, from 1 to 20, we are writing from here. You can see here how many bits we have. 1 to 20 here, like this. So whatever value this k is, that goes into PC in this way, but the LSB of PC remains zero, or actually it is made zero. Now why this happens, or why is it done so? Any guesses? Well, I will tell you. If you can recall, all our instructions are how many bits? Either 16 bit or 32 bit. Only 4 instructions we have which are 32 bit. Rest of the 73 instructions are all 16 bits. And in the program memory, when we have the program memory, okay, the ROM, okay, at each location, how many bits we can save? Only 8 bits. See here, the memory is 2 megabyte. Means each location is going to held only, each location is going to hold only 8 bits. Means for any instruction, minimum 2 bytes will be required, right? For any instruction, minimum 2 bytes will be required. And maximum how many bytes will be required? Maximum 4 bytes will be required for any instruction, right? At least 2 and at most 4 bytes. So what it means is all the instructions, means all the program, when it is starting from location 0 by default, the instruction will always be at 0, then 2, then 4, then 6, then 8, then A, right? You cannot have an instruction. An instruction cannot start at odd numbers, at odd addresses. 1, no instruction can start because the first instruction itself is going to take at least 2 bytes, right? At least 2 bytes are required for one instruction. So instruction is going to always start from an even address. And what is, how to ensure that an address is even? If you have 00011011, how to confirm whether a number is even or odd? Just check the LSB. If LSB is 0, the number is even. You can see for yourself also. If LSB is 0, the number is even. If LSB is 1, number is odd. You can see any binary number and see and confirm yourself. If LSB is 0, the number is even. And that's what we want to ensure here, that the whenever we are jumping to any location, we want to make sure that we want to cross verify that the address at which we are jumping must be an address of the instruction, the full address, the actual starting address of the instruction. We don't want an intermediate address or intermediate value inside an instruction to ensure that the LSB of PC is made 0. Okay. Now, some of the other things that you see on this particular slide is what you see. This instruction is 2 words instruction, means this is a 32 bit instruction. This go to instruction is 32 bit instruction. Okay. Now this is obvious because you can see 20 bits are required for this address itself, right? 20 bits are required here for storing the jumping address where we want to jump. Okay. So rest of the things, obviously we need some space for the opcode. That's why it is not going to fit in 16 bits. That's why what we have in our PKTNF, it is fixed. Either you fit your instruction is 16 bits or go for 32 bits. And because of this, this instruction is a 2-word instruction, means 32-bit instruction. Okay. So what are the takeaways from this instruction? Go to instruction is an unconditional branch. You don't need to verify any condition before jumping. Just an example you can see is here. Example, what you say, instruction go to, and there is some kind of a label. Okay. What will happen after execution of the instruction? The address of this particular label, the address of this particular label will go to PC at the end of the execution of this instruction. Now, as the definition of PC, what we know, program counter holds the address of the next instruction to be executed. That is the definition that we have already seen multiple number of times. So if at the time of execution of this go to instruction itself, if I change the contents of PC, if I change the contents of program counter to something else, to some other address, then once the instruction ends, once the execution of go to instruction ends, it is going to execute the next instruction. The address of this instruction is this new address, right? So this new instruction will be now executed after go to. That is how we are jumping from the current sequence to some other location. So it may look like something this. We are running the program one after the other, but as go to comes here, okay, to let's say label is L1, then there are still some instructions and here is that L1. So if this instruction comes, the program counter will automatically load the address of this instruction and these intermediate instructions will be skipped and the program will execute this instruction. Remember, it is not necessary that go to this L1 or the label is farther away. It is not necessary. It can be some previous locations also. It is what was in the first example that we have seen in this second unit, right? We have seen one example where the jumping address was before go to instruction. Okay, so that is that way also it is possible. Now the problem again is this is a what? Two-word instruction means it is going to need 32 bits of program memory. So to shorten this space, there is another instruction which is available. Okay. Okay, we'll see that in the next slide. But the point I was talking about, see, the 20 bits have been fitted in this instruction like this. Okay, 20 bit address, and note down this zero of the program counter. This is the 21 bit program counter. This is how the address which is provided in the go to instruction goes into program counter. Note down this last bit or the LSB of the program counter. It is always made zero by default in the go to instruction. Okay, the K or the address what we are providing is, or the value we are providing is FFFFF. So actual address of the program memory that is getting loaded is this, means FFFFF, and this zero bit. This is only a bit. Okay, these are all 4-bit values, and a last bit, or you can see here, once we write this K0 to K19 here, there has to be 10 additional. Okay, means we are writing 21 bit full address, but the last bit of the address is always zero. This is how we are going to cover the entire program memory range. If you have any questions, you can ask. Okay, you can unmute yourself and ask any question regarding this go to instruction and how it is executing. Okay, now as I was saying, this instruction is a 4-byte instruction, means 32-bit instruction. There is an alternative short unconditional jump instruction which is called branch. This is unconditional branch instruction, but it is a short branch instruction. What I mean by short branch? BRA, standing for branch. Now what short branch means is, you can see here, instead of go to, the instruction is now BRA, and instead of that K, here it is N. And if you have noted the range of K, see here, here also you can see the range of K was 0 to FFFF. Okay, range of K was 0 to FFFFF, means how many bits it was? 20 bits, right? Now if you note down the value or the range of this N, it is -1024 to 1023. How many bits is it? It is actually, you see here, how many bits it is? 3 + 4 + 4. It is 11 bits, right? Now this 11 bits is 10 bits for the value and 1 bit for the sign, right? -1024 means -2 raised to 10 to 2 raised to 10 plus 2 raised to 10 minus 1, -2 raised to 10 to 2 raised to 10 minus 1. This is the range of this value N. Okay, so you can see instead of 20 bits in the go to, here it is taking only 11 bits. Okay, now it is possible to fit this instruction in within the 16 bit range. right? Because this is the opcode give of this instruction, and within 16 bits the whole instruction can now fit. Okay, so this is only a single word instruction or 16 bit instruction. But now what has altered the way this instruction is going to function is again unconditional branch, means there is no need of checking any condition for branching or for jumping, but there is a range involved in this instruction. There is a limitation up to which we can jump before or after. Like there was a condition in the BC type of instruction, BC, BNC, BZ, BNZ instructions, there was some condition that the jumping address had to be within 256 bytes of the current location of the current instruction. Similar kind of condition or similar kind of range has been imposed in this instruction, that when we are jumping to some other location, that location has to be within this particular range. Okay. However, for our practical purposes, it is not going to affect much, because our programs are not going to be that large, having like 1000 instructions. We are not going to write that large programs, at least in our current course. Okay. So we don't need to worry about this particular range. Okay. For our purposes, we can use this instruction for unconditional branching. Okay. The way we are going to use it is similar to go to. Okay. We can write the instruction and the label where we want to go. Okay. And after the execution, the PC will contain the address of whatever label we have provided in the instruction. The address of that label will go into PC. So at the end of this instruction, the contents of the PC will be modified. Therefore, instead of executing like what we saw in the at the time of go to instruction, if I have this L2 label somewhere here, anywhere I can write. Okay. So when there are some instructions in between, but when this comes up, this instruction executes, the program automatically jumps to the label given here. And how this jumping happens? Simply by modifying the contents of program counter. The program counter gets modified by this particular operation. Contents of PC and 2's complement of the number provided here gets added to that, and it goes into PC. That's how the address of this L2 gets written onto PC, onto the program counter, and program counter, as it holds the address of next instruction, it starts executing from this location further. Okay. We can use these instructions n number of times, doesn't matter. Means I can jump from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, anywhere I can jump. Okay. It is not nothing like a sequential jumping, or there is no condition for this go to and BRA instructions. No condition at all. Whatever the label you put in here, both these instructions will just, without checking any condition, will execute the instruction written at that particular label. Okay. Do you have any questions until this point? Any questions until this point? Okay. So there is one thing that we may sometimes need is the infinite loops, just to keep on holding, nothing doing. It is not going to do anything. Just infinite loops can be implemented in the assembly. just see here, go to here. As per the syntax, this thing written here is the label where we want to jump. But if I give the same label to this instruction, what will happen? What will happen? Actually, while goto is getting executed, the address of next instruction, whatever it is here, is in the PC. But after executing goto, the address of label here will be loaded into PC. So PC will again execute this instruction. Means PC will continue, or the microcontroller will continue executing the same instruction over and over again. Okay. This statement can also be written like this. Go to dollar. This is the dollar sign. Okay. And this particular syntax is automatically translated into go to K, where the K is the address of the same instruction go to. That automatic translation gets done by the assembler. Similarly, this BRA instruction can also be implemented for infinite loops. Okay. And the same thing, BRA dollar, this is also possible. Now, what I am saying here is better way to implement the infinite loops is to use this BRA instruction. Can somebody tell me why? What I am saying, instead of go to, it is better to use BRA in for this infinite loop thing. Okay. Can someone tell me why? Why this is better, or why this is better than this? Or what is that? Yes.
Because go to is 32-bit instruction and BSR is smaller than it.
Yes, correct. Because this is going to take 32 bits. This is going to take 16 bits, right? And since we don't want to jump anywhere else, we are jumping on the same instruction. So there is no problem of that range for BRA instruction. So we can use this instruction for infinite loop and we can save 2 bytes of our program memory, right? Okay. So you have any questions? No. Now on the next slide, I am going to show you some questions. Okay. And what you have to do is you have to send your answers in the chat box and also make sure that you are not replying to all. Right. You know what I'm saying? When you go into the chat and when you write your when you type something, you can see to that chat is going to someone, right? There is everyone option. Instead of that everyone, select the option to only me. Me means me, right? Change that option to me and then send your answers. Okay. These are very simple questions, whatever we have learned from until now. Okay. So I'm going to show you these questions.